in our sugaring setup, there's a quite big gap in the stovepipe. Might surprise you to not see smoke coming out of it, because there's smoke coming out of the top. But chimney effect is a really strong one. And that is when you have hot air in a like a vertical space, or not even precisely vertical, the hot air will rise, and that can deal with like big gaps like that. But not completely. There's a little gap there, the top piece. This is, there's four pieces of this, and this is between the bottom and the next one up. But between the there's another one there, and at the top, there's a small gap, and that's letting out smoke. And I think that's probably because the chimney effect isn't as strong higher up, or it's starting to have some back pressure of the top, kind of not letting it out super well.
With our wood cook stove, another aspect of the chimney effect can be seen. When the stove is going, the smoke and hot gases from the firebox, which is over here, go over the top of the oven, down under, and then back along the bottom, and up this vent, and then over this, I guess, hump, and then up the chimney and out through the top of our roof. So that's a kind of roundabout way. And what's happening is that because there's enough vertical, like there's substantially more vertical, and in theory it could even work with just more, not even need to be substantially more, but in practice you want quite a big chimney of high outlet vertical. Because that tall vertical is there, it's able to kind of, well, create a suction here that's drawing air in through the air vents in air vents are over on this side of the stove, drawing air in, burning it, getting really hot, and then that hot air wants to go up. And that even though it has to go down in the process of getting to going up, there's enough suction of that vertical so that it can do that roundabout loop. But when we're starting it, there's the little valve there that, so now with that open, the gases just have to go up, and they don't have, well, they do have to go down over there, but just in the stove internally, they don't have to go down. And one thing that can happen is that on warmer days, it can actually be harder to start a wood stove because there isn't as much of a temperature differential causing the air to go up, because even though the fire inside this is much, much hotter than like the room temperature, but on a cold day, there's enough of a differential between the outside air and the inside air, which that could get up to like 90 degrees Fahrenheit difference, to cause a draft to start occurring. You can start the fire really easily because that draft is already occurring and you don't need to create it. But that draft is strong enough that when I have a fire going and the thing is pushed in, even so it has to go this kind of loopy roundabout route, I can open this door and no smoke comes out, even though it'd be really easy for it to come out here and just into the room, but there's enough of a draw when I have a good fire going that it just goes up and out the chimney, even though there's this huge, and it's sucking more air in here.
Back out at the stove, you can see that there's even a pretty significant gap at the top that there's no smoke coming out of because the suction from the chimney is so great. However, if I open up the door and add a bunch more air to this, smoke starts coming out because that suction can't keep up with this massive gaping hole here. So the air wants to flow out that way with the smoke in it.
The lack of draft when you start a fire is also one reason why you need a lot more air to start a fire. with the vents open wider. Once the fire is going, that suction created by the chimney draws in air for the fire to burn.